Hello, good morning everyone. My name is Krishnendu Chatterjee and we are here to on our BFSI industrial dialogue, you know, on BFSI and workforce empowerment and how bridging financial gaps for growth. The BFSI sector is pivotal to socioeconomic development. The industry helps bridge critical financial gaps by offering a wide range of tailored financial products and services such as microfinance, insurance, vehicle loans, housing, agricultural loans, digital payments solutions, which are essential for supporting individuals, small businesses, and underserved population. The increased access to financial services drives economic growth and development. Just to give you some figures, banking sector clocked a CAGR of around 12 to 14%, with the private sector growing above 15% over the last 3 to 5 years, while NBFCs largely has been clocking anywhere between 18 to 20% CAGR during the same period. The credit card market in India has grown by at least 20% CAGR over the last 5 years. And we are seeing an exponential growth in digital payments, which has seen a 44% CAGR growth in the last 5 years, with transaction volumes rising from 2,000 crores to about 18,000 crores with UPI alone at a growth rate of 129%. Over the past decade, the BFSI sector has undergone significant transformation driven by growing demand for flexible, innovative, and accessible financial solutions. As of 2023, the overall asset size of the BFSI sector has seen a substantial growth, particularly in segments like retail, banking, credit cards, insurance, financial technology. BFSI companies play an essential role in market penetration, contributing to initiatives like financial inclusion, which is crucial to achieve the national development goals. To explore these themes, I'm joined by Mr. Kumar Gaurav, Lead HR at Hero FinCorp, offering valuable insights into sector's workforce dynamics and future prospects. Mr. Kumar Gaurav brings around 2 decades of extensive experience across industries in the HR management and operations, having held positions at renowned organizations such as AON, Hewitt, Agilis Diagnostic, Take Care India, which was Videocon Group, and ATC Telecom. He currently serves as a lead HR for Hero FinCorp. Welcome, Gaurav.
Thank you, Krishnendu, for calling me. And it is an opportunity where I will be getting some good insight on the NBFC and also will try to bring some light on the today's current topic. So thank you once again.
Thank you. Thanks, Gaurav. Thanks for joining in. So I'll start with you, Gaurav. So how do you see the BFSI sector shaping India's financial landscape, especially in terms of market penetration and government's plan of financial inclusion? I mean, you know, Hero FinCorp largely also works in microfinancing, small loans, etc., which is part of government's financial inclusiveness. So how do you see
Okay, so when I'm talking about on this thing, NBFC in today's time is playing a very crucial bridge in financial ecosystem. We are connecting to underserved population with essential financial services, and by enhancing the accessibility, we will be able to offer diversity or you can say diverse range of product, and prompting the financial literacy between the people who are actually not the target audience earlier when the private, non-private banks was, the government banks was there. Okay. So when we are talking about NBFC, means it is providing individual and a small business that offer lack access by banking services due to credit worthy enabling borrower and limited on no credit history, such as those things in the rural or basically the lower income urban areas. So when we are talking about NBFC or basically when I'm talking about Hero FinCorp, so being an NBFC, so our target is again the rural and semi-urban areas where we are extending our reach to the population that may not have access to traditional banking, like for a person who is doing all the earning in cash. Okay, if the person is want to go for a two-wheeler loan, okay, or in case they want to go for any kind of a business loan. So the traditional banking system will not be able to provide that. But being into the rule of RBI, NBFC can extend the financial help to that particular person. So, and second is the reach to the very remote areas. For example, if you see, refer to the 7 states of India, except Guwahati, if you believe and think after, before 5 years, okay, there was only the private, sorry, the government banks, and they're extending support to a level. But now if you'll see, you will get everything available there. And with the help of technology, it is getting very easy to reach them through the mobile application or the web applications. So, of course, this is the thing what NBFC is creating into the market, reaching to the people.
Right.
Yeah.
Specific to your organization, how, you know, the organizations are strategizing. So the example you gave about Northeast, for example, you know, where, you know, the world was, there was no world beyond Guwahati now. And now, you know, you see every NBFC, private bank. So specific to your organization, what are your strategies to penetrate into these undeserved region or untapped market, as we say?
So when you're talking about penetrating to such kind of places where the people are not touched till yet, okay, so expanding, the hero also believe into that thing, and we are expanding our business into those areas which are basically not penetrated by the market till now. Example, I have given like 7 states right now.
Right.
So we are also focused into that areas. We are also focused for our major business, if you'll say, it is into like a state like Bihar. Bihar is having a very good market potential earlier, because I believe belong to that particular place. I know earlier, 10 years back, there was no credit card, there was no loan system other than the government bank.
Correct.
We are also approaching to the microfinancing, like kind of a thing, like business loan, MSME loan kind of a thing is also, which is now provided by NBFC or especially from the hero end. So that is also creating a good value into the market, and it is giving the customer reach. Earlier, if it is the traditional bank, they required a guarantor before giving any kind of loan.
Mm-hmm.
But we as an organization, we believe into the paperwork, and accordingly, we also see the total liability of the person, and accordingly, we extend the our services to them. It can be n number of things. The major is the two-wheeler loan right now.
Yeah. Okay. And I mean, you know, with this expansion, Gaurav, how do you see job opportunities growing within the NBFC sectors? Of course, you also mentioned that there is a large part of it is also driven by digital means and methods. But overall, how do you see job opportunities within the NBFC sectors?
So, I want to answer this question to two different parts. First is the technology-related thing, and second to the human-related thing, the job opportunity point. So, when we are talking about the technology-related thing, of course, technology played a very pivotal role into connecting people. Because it is giving, the digital platforms are giving very user-friendly loan, the application are very user-friendly. It also provide immediate customer interaction, as well as the overall experience of customer is getting increased day by day. Absolutely. Not only that, if you go to the background, so it is also helping NBFC or to see the non-traditional data like social media behavior, payment history assessment. Okay, with the help of AI, we also have some kind of risk management thing which is built in for the credit score and all. So these are the things which is actually helping NBFC to make a decision. Now, when we are talking about the job opportunities, okay, so definitely you it will help to create the job opportunity if we will be penetrating to the remote areas, urban areas or semi-urban areas, because these are working on a community kind of a culture where if somebody, one person is penetrated, it will go to another, one customer will go to another and to third, because people there are using technology, but that technology is for support, that is not for the front-ending. So, of course, that will right. help for job creation, because there we would require manpower. Correct. And that manpower will be not in some hundreds or thousands. If we are talking about the entire NBFC, it can go to lakhs also, depend upon Correct. The market penetration.
Correct.
Yeah.
Correct. No, I think that's actually a great point you mentioned. Continuing on this, Gaurav, so I have been meeting a lot of our clients and prospects, and one of the things which has come out is from a gender diversity perspective, we have seen that there is, a huge, thing towards, male employees, specifically to the front end staff and, feet on street, etc. Specifically to these, far-fetched places and remote places, how are you seeing make BFSI a much more inclusive kind of an industry?
If you're talking about feet on the street, and especially to the remote or urban areas, the unpenetrated market, okay, of course, the diversity will help like anything, because when we are talking about a community, the community can be penetrated by any gender, any diversity. But of course, if somebody is from that particular community only, that give an additional benefit to the organization.
Yeah.
Now, second yeah. thing is, once the community, once you will have that person on board, it will be very easy to be get in touch with the entire community one by one or in a group also. We as an organization, when we are talking about diversity, we are it's not only the gender diversity, it can be the diversity related to the caste, religion, area. So of course, these things help as an added advantage into the market penetration.
Right. Slightly moving on to the discussion we were having, Gaurav. So NBFCs we have seen, slowly and gradually becoming as regulated as a bank, and given that regulation heavy nature within the BFSI sector, specifically the NBFCs, how do you see the industry addressing these challenges from a regulatory compliance perspective, while continue to innovate, while continue to grow, etc.? So what's your thoughts on those?
So this is a kind of a balancing act, basically. And that is required a strategical approach to achieve the dual goal. Okay. Mm-hmm. By regulatory monitoring and engaging with regulator helped us to stay informed on any change in the regulatory or compliance requirement throughout right. the industry. So that definitely helped us to get the things in line with the regulation. Mm-hmm. Plus our innovation, when we are talking about innovation, it start from the product development. So at right. from that time only, if the organization are focused on the regulatory compliances, we will design our product like that only, so that it will go as per the compliance and there should not be any fault. As well as when we're talking about Hero, we have a culture where we also get in touch with the customer with the required compliance. So we educate the customer from the day one. So there should not be any kind of a dispute happen because of the technology or the regulatory. So that is also giving a trust between the organization. As well as I think like if there should be a group of NBFCs or the representative of the NBFC should also meet on a regular basis, having some kind of a group where we should be sharing our innovation and our compliance related issues. So that means it will create an industry bridge also that will help each others to grow within that.
I think you have driven a great idea for us to do the next event, where I think we will talk about the whole regulatory aspect, because mm-hmm. it kind of touches everyone, right, including yeah, us as a service provider. Mm-hmm. So I think it will be an informed discussion, and really look forward to this.
Definitely, I will be love to be the part of that also.
Yes, yes, look forward to.
Thank you.
So talking of the product, Gaurav, and I know you kind of touched upon a little at the early. Now, you know, if you look at the credits now, it has kind of, the kind of credits which are being offered are more like a bite size or sachet size kind of thing. And, you know, with this whole EMI options coming in, we have also seen that the consumer demand has grown up. Like, you know, earlier when we were kids, we have seen our parents that, you know, we used to wait for special occasion to get that TV, get that fridge, get that washing machine. But because of this sachets, you know, size or bite size financial services being offered, it has become much more accessible, you know. And especially if you look at the trend now, you know, your new set of consumers are basically the Gen Zs and the millennials, etc. So as a financial services provider, what are you doing to cope up to A, you know, such requirements or such client base, and B, how far you think this bite size, sachet size things will help us grow, you know, both as an economy and as a consumer market as a whole?
So if you're talking about the this bite size of things, okay, it has been gradually increase in last 7-8 years. Now the people are more focused on the having a zero EMI kind of a zero interest kind of a EMI. Okay, yeah. And starting from, if you see the digital platform, of course, digital platforms have helped all NBFCs to design these kind of products, starting from an online shopping portal to credit card to different kind of lending applications. Okay,
right.
So these things are actually helping the entire population in India, starting from a buyer to a seller, to a banker, all three. When the buyer have some need, if somebody want to have an iPhone and cannot be able to spend 1 lakh rupees at a time, but the person right. can be able to spend 10,000 rupees. So he will right. get, he or she will get the iPhone, but in an equal installment. Similarly, right. the seller is getting one more sale done because of this EMI kind of a thing.
Correct.
Similarly, the bank is also having that interest thing will get there. So it is like a supply chain kind of a or the life cycle is designed there. So
Correct.
This is the way it is helping to grow the Indian economy also, because ultimately it is the taxation and other things are helping to the government in terms of their growth.
Absolutely. Absolutely. And coming to the festive season, so we are all getting ready for festive season, and you know, we are already seeing. So one good thing which we have seen, Gaurav, is, you know, after 2 years of lull, the FMCD sector is kind of growing at a good pace after 2 years, you know, after recovering out of the COVID. You know, how does NBFCs, you know, and for NBFCs, it's a pretty competitive space with so many NBFCs trying to lure customer and offering good rate of interest, discounts, cashbacks, etc. So how is Hero FinCorp preparing, you know, for the festive season? Do you have any specific offerings or anything you want to, you know, discuss about, which will specifically, you know, benefit the customer and also create growth opportunities?
Yeah. So Krishnendu, in this basically for us or the NBFC, this festive season was started 1 month back only, when we have started penetrating the dealer distributor. There are the schemes which have been launched for I'm specifically talking about two-wheeler, because this time two-wheeler sales are on a higher side.
Correct.
So penetrating to the dealer distributor, as well as we are having different kind of offers for customer who is taking two-wheeler loan from us. The main important thing, instead of giving kind of an offer or any kind of scheme to the person, now people are is more interested to get things on a timely manner, the speedy manner. So how much time you are taking to process the entire file impact? So this year we are also coming with a new application, so which will help us to do the financing within the 15 minutes from the login. So that Correct. Will definitely help the entire organization to penetrate the market.
Correct. Oh, okay, great. Great points, Gaurav. Thanks for all the great input. So before we wind up, you know, and this is for every one of us, and since you are in the nerve center of the industry, you know, what are your final thoughts on the future growth prospects for the BFSI sector? And, you know, with India touted to be the third largest economy, maybe in next couple of years, and we're looking at becoming a developed nation, maybe in another 20 years, you know, how do you see BFSI sector driving this entire thing for the future?
So, BFSI definitely will help to grow the grow entire economy, because the BFSI is not only limited to offering different kind of financial services like having loans or credit. They are now also into insurance. They are also into MSME. They are into collateral loans and all. So these things will definitely help to the grow India, because if I am a borrower or if I am a businessman, I will definitely require money to run the entire show. And BFSI providing a credit line kind of a thing to them is helping to borrow the money instantly as per the need. And if you're talking right. about down the line, 20 years, yes, of course, these things will help. Your technology, your speed of service, and your market penetration, that will help BFSI to grow, and BFSI will vice versa help the entire community to grow in that.
Exactly. Yeah, that's actually a great, yeah, because at the end of the day, it has to be an inclusive growth.
Yeah.
I think, you know, BFSI with all the services and product available actually caters to the entire population, right? And exactly. I think that's the inclusiveness which we are looking at. With that, it's a wrap. Thanks, Gaurav. Thanks for your time and, you know, your insights. I think these are great insights, and, you know, our listeners and our viewers will immensely, you know, appreciate your thoughts. So with that, thank you very much and have a great day, Gaurav.
Thank you, Krishnendu. Thank you, TeamLease, for giving this platform where I am actually been able to give my thoughts to others. Thanks a lot.
Thank you very much.